These bullet ants are showing some worrying symptoms. Spores from a parasitic fungus called cordyceps have infiltrated their bodies and their minds.
Sound familiar? The infected that roam the post-apocalypse of Naughty Dog's The Last of Us may have taken inspiration from real fungi, but how accurate is it? And what else did the developers use as the basis for the apocalypse? To find out, let's take a look at the real science of The Last of Us. The fungi, Ophiocordyceps unilateralis, infects ants when spores attach themselves, penetrate the exoskeleton, and overtake its behavior. The ant soon leaves the nest to look for a humid microclimate where the fungus can grow. It moves about 10 inches off the ground, where it attaches itself to a leaf and awaits its death as the fungus feeds on its innards. Several days after the ant's death, the fungus sprouts a fruiting body through the ant's head, which distributes spores in an attempt to infect even more ants. Now, the main difference with the cordyceps fungus in The Last of Us is that it has made the leap from insects to humans, which, due to the genome of the fungus, simply isn't possible in its current state. There's a blog post over on Destructoid that looks into this in more scientific detail. In a world where the virus could make the leap to humans, though, Naughty Dog has taken several creative liberties by contrasting and extending the real-world impact that the fungus has on ants. While the process between infection and death in an ant can take from 4 to 10 days, in The Last of Us it can take several years, sometimes over a decade, for the host to succumb to the virus. In this time, they undergo several stages of infection. Within 2 days, they lose their higher brain function and become hyper-aggressive. Within 2 weeks, the virus starts to alter the host's sight. Within a year, they are blind and develop a primitive form of echolocation. And in rare cases where the host survives for over 10 years, they develop hardened fungal plates which act as a sort of armor. Like with ants, once the virus has killed the host, the fungus continues to grow through plants that sprout out of the body. These emit spores that infect other humans who breathe them, and the cycle of the virus continues. Interestingly, more recent research has demonstrated that the fungus doesn't invade the brains of ants, it only interferes with the host's nervous system and controls its muscles. So if the virus in the game really is the next step from the one in real life, perhaps Sam's fear wasn't so irrational.
Those things out there. What if the people are still inside? What if they're trapped in there without any control of their body? I'm scared of that happening to me.
Once a pandemic of this magnitude hits a country like the United States, what happens next? Shortly after we see the outbreak hit, the game jumps ahead 20 years, so we don't get to see a response in real time, but the game's title sequence gives us a little more information through snippets of news reports.
The number of confirmed deaths has passed 200.
First of all, state governors began to declare a state of emergency. This is almost certainly the first thing that would happen in a real-life pandemic like this. In fact, we have recent precedent for it. Once COVID-19 began gaining traction in the United States in late February and early March this year, 21 states declared a state of emergency before President Donald Trump did the same for the entire nation. For the states, this declaration gives the governor and their emergency team some additional powers to deal with the emergency in whatever way is required, such as by deploying the National Guard or imposing mandatory evacuations. At a nationwide level, the federal government can step in. In the case of COVID-19, the Department of Health and Human Services has permission to make changes deemed necessary. In the game, the Federal Disaster Response Agency took control and dismantled the existing government. The next event that occurred in the game was Los Angeles being placed under martial law, and riots were reported for several days. Martial law has been declared several times in the United States during times of national emergency, but due to its nature, the power is rarely exercised. Once martial law has been declared, most civil rights are suspended, and the military takes control of law enforcement duties, allowing them to enact curfews and demand identification papers in public. Despite martial law rarely being declared in recent history, the military has been deployed on some occasions, such as the 1992 riots in Los Angeles and the recent George Floyd protests across the United States. The main opposers of military rule in The Last of Us is the revolutionary group Fireflies, who aim to eventually restore the US government. Such a group is not at all uncommon. There are many active and historical rebel militia groups fighting against the military and government, including some in the US. Following the military execution of several fireflies, the group held demonstrations and riots against the military quarantine zones, some of which were successful. In real life, demonstrations are a common way to project one's voice for or against a particular subject, like anti-war protests, LGBT and women's marches, and of course, the George Floyd protests. Interestingly, one of the most accurate elements of the pandemic response in The Last of Us is a lack of preparedness. Advances in medicine and science have certainly given us an extra step in preparing for a deadly virus, but social evolution has done the opposite. The world now has more people living much closer together and often traveling alongside each other with little distancing. In fact, studies showed that no countries were truly prepared for a pandemic. There's a reason COVID-19 has been so destructive after all. That's not to say that the US is completely unprepared though. Fears of bioterrorism after 9/11 prompted the mass production of vaccine and antitoxin for smallpox and anthrax, for example, so the country is still overprepared there. But some pandemics, be it COVID-19 or the cordyceps infection, are just too difficult to predict, and delaying emergency protocols just makes tackling them even harder. 60% of the world's population disappearing within a number of months will certainly have a strong impact on the planet, and The Last of Us makes no secret of it. The developers based a lot of the world on the hypothetical scenario described by professor and author Alan Weisman in his book The World Without Us, for which he interviewed scientists and academics to discover what would happen to the world if humans suddenly disappeared. Mere hours after being abandoned, oil refineries would explode and burn for months, which would explain a lot of the damage that can be found within the game. Abandoned drainage pumps would flood underground rail tunnels, a regular sight in the game. Within a week, most emergency generators would shut down, and for the most part, the earth would go dark. Within 20 years, weeds and tree roots have torn apart sidewalks. The flooded underground tunnels have eroded the concrete and turned streets into rivers. Internal leaking pipes destroy concrete buildings, forcing them to collapse and cause more destruction. The destruction is a little less obvious in rural areas, but there's still evidence of what's happened. Leaks, mold, and infestation of bugs and rodents. In the cities, plants spread wildly and are followed by animals who use the new plant locations to venture to new areas. Sadly, most domesticated animals can't survive, save for a few capable dogs, pigs, and feral cats. Birds, however, thrive without humans. The reduced light population saves more than 1 billion birds as they are able to migrate properly. It's unlikely that we'll ever get to see any of this ever happen in our lifetime, so to see it visualized through a video game is the next best thing. We've already had a chance to see how the world responds to a pandemic, but if the virus was as deadly as the cordyceps fungi, perhaps things would have gone a lot differently. Naughty Dog has taken real-world inspirations to build the world of The Last of Us, not only to feel incredibly deep and storied, but also so real and based on scientific theory. And now, with the release of The Last of Us Part 2, I'm fascinated to see where Naughty Dog goes next.